Hey, welcome back. It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, and Mike Gervin, the real Excel is fun, not that joker who's out there trying to steal Mike's identity. Today, podcast episode, Dueling Excel podcast episode 79, percentage of parent. All right, this is going to be a three-parter. I have two different ways to do this. We're trying to come up with a pivot table that shows the Dallas market as a percentage of the central region. So let's first start with the pivot table, insert pivot table. I'm going to go to an existing worksheet right there, bam, and click OK. We want, along the left-hand side, we want region and then market, and I want to see total revenue. Okay, I want to come up with a percentage of Chicago divided by central region. Chicago divided by central region, and this is brand new in Excel 2010, a really, really easy way to do this. I drag it down there a second time, go to the second version. Let's scroll over here a little bit, and up in our pivot table tools, let's see, under calculations, show values as new in Excel 2010, percentage of parent row total. All right, now this is a lot easier than the old way, although, you know, I understand that 35.57 is the east percentage of the grand total. I get that. It never feels right to me to see those numbers there. But anyway, that's the Excel 2010 way. Mike, let's see the old way, the way that we would do back in Excel 2007 or Excel 2003.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Wow, that pivot table, that percentage of parent new calculation, I love it. I use it in statistics all the time. In earlier versions, though, we had to get a little tricky here. Here's our data set. I'm just going to add an extra column. Percent of parent can't type so well. Now, over in this pivot table right here, we already have the sum right here for Baltimore in the east or Chicago in the central. And then we simply, to get this 16%, we say, hey, this divided by the total. But over here, what if we said this equals the actual little bitty revenue, this hasn't been summarized yet, divided by sum if. The sum if what? Remember, Dallas, we need the total for Dallas and then compare it the total for the central region. Well, we can add up all the central region. We could say the range, here's the criteria, control shift down arrow F4, comma, this right here. So as we go down, this will be locked, this one. So as we move down, it'll always get the total, comma, the sum range. Well, that's going to be this right here. Now, what is this going to do? This is going to be an actual small percentage. But all of the Dallases, if we were to add them up, where's another Dallas? Right here. So there's, we have a little 3% here for Dallas. And then we also have another one here, a little 2%. Well, if we add all those up, we get our percent of total. So now I'm going to create a pivot table, Alt-NVT. That's the keyboard shortcut in 2007 and 10. Existing worksheet. I'm going to click right here and click OK. All right, I'm going to take the region down here, the market right down here. So now we have that little right there. And I'm just going to drop the percent of total right there. And boom, the default is sum. And sure enough, that gets our percent. We could right click, value field settings, number. We always want to do it this way because it sticks when you pivot it. And then I'm going to say percentage. Click OK, click OK. And there we have it. Not showing the 30 or whatever we had over here, whatever we had down there for. But there you go. We have the same actual percentages right here. All right, throw it back to Mr. Excel.
Hey, Mike, that is cool. I love this formula. Although, you know, I've used that in the past, not many times. It's horrible when you get 100,000 rows. It just takes forever. Let's try a power pivot solution to this. So I have my original data set. Create a linked table in the Power Pivot tab. Click OK. All right, there's my data. I'll take this back as a pivot table. New worksheet, that's great. Let's put region, market, and then revenue. All right, now here's where the power of Power Pivot comes in. Take a look at this cell. How many filters are applied to that cell? There's actually two filters. The first filter says, hey, the market has to be Chicago, and the second filter says the region has to be central. We're going to do a calculation here. I'm going to say new measure, and the calculation is going to be equal calculate. Calculate is kind of like sum if. I want the sum of table 1 revenue, and then here's the filters. Now normally in a sum if you apply filters to the data. Here I'm actually going to remove a filter. I'm going to say I want to apply all the filters that are naturally upon that cell of the pivot table. So this cell has two filters. It has market equals Chicago, region equals central. But in this case I'm going to say, well wait, for the market I don't want any filter at all. I want all of the markets. All of the markets. So all table 1 market, close the calculate. Now, you know, these formulas are so new and different. I always check the formula, and no errors in formula. You have to click check formula and then hold down check formula, otherwise the tooltip covers up the result. And what are we going to call this? We're going to call this revenue for region. There we go. Click OK. All right, and check that out. Now, it's only doing calculations here, 15 calculations. So if you had 100,000 rows, it wouldn't have to do 100,000 calculations and add them up. It's literally only doing this 15. And the beautiful thing here is that for Chicago, it's showing us the total revenue for the central region. All right, so a very fast way to do that. Now that we have that measure, let's create one new measure. And we'll call this percent of region. And the answer is going to be, all right, so we have our existing table 1 revenue. That has to be equal sum of table 1 revenue divided by that measure, table 1. I can just put the measure name in there, revenue for region. Parentheses look OK. Check formula. Yep, that looks good. Let's click OK. Cross our fingers. Ah, there we go. Nice. Now we need to format that. So that's back on the pivot table. Field settings, number format, percentage. Let's go with 1. Click OK. Click OK. And the same answer that Mike came up with, but with a large data set, you know, even with in Power Pivot, 100 million rows, this is going to be very, very quick because they only have to do this calculation 15 times, this calculation 15 times, and we're done. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.